Hey, I wanna show you something.
I'm Cleo Abram. I'm a video journalist, and I make a show called Huge If True, which is a show about the future of technology. I'm a child of infinite access to information.
What am I actually looking at?
Sifting through all of that is both a privilege and a challenge. I got an email from Google saying, hey, do you want to try this new AI tool that we have in your workflow?
I've written about tools for thought and using software as an augmentation of our intellect on and off for 2 decades now. I had this obsession with the possibility of using technology to help with that writing process. Google Labs said, we can finally build this thing you've been chasing really your whole adult life. Why don't you come help us build it?
Hey, Cleo.
Hello. I'm working on this video about egg freezing, a journalistic deep dive into how it works and what the implications are, and also partly following me as I'm gonna do it myself. I'm feeling a little bit nervous, but honestly, doing the research helps a lot. And I'm using Notebook LM, which is the tool that I've been testing out for Google.
It's a tool to help you research, think, take notes. We like to say that this software is designed to help you get to your first draft faster.
There's not a name for this in my existing process, which I think is kind of the point. Like, it's a memory helper. It's like a really good retriever.
We've started to look for people who bring a new set of expectations.
What I'm good at is figuring out the Rubik's Cube of using your eyes and your ears at the same time and writing a script that makes good use of both.
She's making videos, not writing books.
The thing that makes Notebook LM cool is it's only answering the questions that I ask it based on the resources that I provide.
So I'm still going out and finding the journal articles myself. I'm still reading all of them. With Notebook LM, I'm querying my own research more easily. I'm not just searching a term, I'm searching concepts. I can search that research better and less gets lost.
So for example, what are the risks of egg freezing? It's summarizing really, really well. Shockingly well, actually, wow. Okay, I'm definitely gonna wanna save this.
One direction we're going, encouraged by talking to you, is the fact-checking process. So you just click on verify with sources, and it analyzes the text you've selected.
And it's verifying with my sources that I gave it previously. Yes!
Right? And then you have citations down at the bottom.
This is what I needed.
Right. Yeah,
that's amazing.
Exactly.
It's exciting to be learning how to improve in how I use a tool at the same time as the tool itself is improving. My hope is that we both get better together.
Language models and artificial intelligence are the most important new technology to come along, probably in my lifetime. You can have conversations with complex documents and you can explore them in that way, and it turns out to be a very powerful way to learn.
Drawing the signal from the noise. I do this job because I love that. Like, I love that puzzle.